got you close to the annex, you have a vision and make checks on the case block. And close to the annex now.
The picture screen stands in solitude in both theaters by Hiroshi Sugimoto and The Desert Cantos by Richard Mizrahi. Where the two photographs are separated by a decade, both screens are reunited by their lack of an image, as well as an audience to witness their existence. Ironically, the art of these photographs is created by the actual photographs themselves, and not by the screens in which at one point were used as vessels for artistic expression. Sugimoto and Mizrahi both capture separate images by using their unique styles and technique. At first glance, the two photographs spark a complete contrast in their aesthetic design. However, after closer observation, Sugimoto and Mizrahi both create a similar picture that conveys a similar story. Lighting both photographs creates two images that are visually foreign to each other, yet the effect has the same impact of drawing one's attention to the same object. In theaters, Sugimoto uses the darkness of a theater to frame the illuminated screen.
The point of the photograph that the eye is forcibly drawn to. The light shines outward, exposing what appears to be a stage, and the architecture of the theater, including the ceiling. The light attempts to seep further downward and in between the first two rows of empty seats, causing them to look like rows of teeth. The fading of the light gives the photograph a gothic appearance. Aside from the screen, the only other light comes from the two exit signs, one on each side of the theater. Unlike Sugimoto, Mizrahi's The Desert Cantos uses light across the entire surface of the photograph. Also, unlike Sugimoto, Mizrahi does not utilize a contrast or brightness of light to create a focal point. Mizrahi's photograph blends its colors together, the screen becoming one with the background of sky and clouds. The only separation of color comes from what may be the sun setting, leaving a splash of light on the hills, which then traces off onto the sky in the further distance. Even with the differences in lighting, Mizrahi also accomplishes to make the screen in his photograph the focal point, not by light, but by space. Mizrahi centers the screen to naturally draw one's eyes to the main object. looking at the two photographs, I am taken by the isolation that both picture screens seem to be existing in. At the same time, however, I feel fortunate to be witness to an art that appears to be fading away in both photographs. Although I experience the same kind of reaction from both photographs, Sugimoto manages to inspire a space of intimate fury. The darkness of the theater sets the mood. The illuminated screen playing the role of a mouth whose light screams out to be heard, to be seen. The exit signs act as annoying reminders of where all the absent characters in this photograph have gone. All elements or characters of Sugimoto's photograph are fitting to be set in a theater. In contrast, the feeling of Mizrock's photograph represents more of a sense of defeat, with the blending of the light and the centering of the screen. I cannot help but feel like an era has come to an end. Mizrock persuades me to feel dull, heavy, gray. I feel as though I am witness to a final departure, one that has been succumbed to. Without a fight. From the emotions that come to life by these two photographs, many thoughts come to mind. Mainly, I think of change and the consequences that come with change. With this idea of change, I think of aging and the struggle to accept the inevitable. I also think of the day and age in which we live today. The replacement of one form of art by another that reflects our society's demands of new and better, meaning younger and faster. These photographs reflect today's absence of gratitude and the lack of appreciation for the history of our past that has led us to our present. Consequently, the two photographs remind me of those who got left behind by not being able to keep up with the change that lives and breathes throughout time. I think of the elderly whose families place them in homes so that they're not burdened with the responsibility of caring for those who once cared for them. I think of being locked up in prison, where time seems to stand still, while the world outside moves on without me. I think of the two picture screens who are being replaced by technology, by which they have no chance of competing with. To change, I think of the universal idea of emotions, if that makes sense. When I look at theaters and the desert cantos, I'm confronted with the separation of class as well as the separation of time and space. Theaters was taken in the 1970s, presumably somewhere in a city, and by the looks of the interior architecture of the theater, a seat probably cost more than a parking space in a drive-in theater. The Desert Cantos was taken in the 1980s in what appears to be in the middle of nowhere, or in the desert, as its name suggests, and represents an audience of mostly young people who are more interested in exploring one another than they are in viewing what is on the screen. these set differences. The two photographs both remind me that no matter where I'm at in the world, what time of day or year it is, and how much money photographs of the two picture screens were captured at different times and within different spaces and are visually different, yet both share the same story and both relay to me the same message. That no one person is ever really alone in their experiences and with their feelings. But
that no one person is ever really alone in their experiences and with their feelings.
That no one person is ever really alone in their experiences and with their feelings. That no one person is ever really alone.